Good evening, everyone. I am Dr. Praveen, private dental practitioner. Today, my topic for e-poster presentation is understanding the bite mark. Bite marks are the bite that bite back both the suspect. If the bite mark analysis is good, and even the forensic odontologist, if the bite mark analysis is not done properly. McDonald defines bite marks as a mark made by the teeth, either alone or in combination with other markers. Bite mark evidence are seen in living person, dead bodies, food substance, and objects, which can be used in civil and criminal investigation. Bite marks occurs during violent fight, sex crimes, child abuse, and burglary. A scientific basis of understanding the bite mark is on the two postulates. Mainly, the human dentition is unique, and this uniqueness is registered or transferred to the skin. So, as an expert in the tooth morphology and knowing the science and knowledge behind the bite marks, forensic odontologists plays an important role in providing testimony on bite marks in the court. So when you are presenting the scientific methodology in your court, the court needs both the methodology and the conclusion. Both are not distinct and one and the same. So this can be supported by Daubert ruling. Daubert ruling says that the test should be tested and testable. It should be peer reviewed and published in the journals. It should have scientific validity principles and measured error ranges. Also, the innocent movement, which was started in 1992 in Law College in New York, was mainly on the aim to exonerate the people who were wrongly convicted with the help of DNA analysis. This happened even in the case of bite mark convicted cases. So the Daubert ruling and the innocent movement clearly says that a scientific methodology before getting admitted into the court should follow certain principles. Now, the evidentiary value of bite marks. In a case of child abuse, the presence of disputed child abuse case, the presence of bite marks makes it a clear-cut case of child abuse. In the case of defendant consensual sex, the presence of bite marks makes it less believable. Sometimes it is an only evidence presented in the crime scene. Also, it acts as a source of salivary DNA and amylase. To know the person behind the bite mark, we should know about the factors influencing the bite mark, those associated with the victim and suspect, and variation in the variability of the skin, that is, the distortion of the skin, anatomical location, tissue underlying the skin, movement during the infliction, and even clothing. The mechanism of action of the bite marks. Anterior tooth comes in contact with the skin. Now the initial tooth and skin interaction takes place. At this point, a low expansion occurs. During this period, the initial teeth sets a diagnostic dental mark on the skin. After further progression, the distortion occurs. During this stage, the remaining teeth comes in contact with the skin and creates sets a mark of teeth. The pathway of teeth into the skin. First, the tooth engages the skin. A local biochemical changes occurs. The skin here becomes tight at the point of contact. At this point, the remaining teeth comes in contact with the teeth, which is less elastic. Now, the viscoelastic nature of the skin. At the low or initial stress, the skin is elastic. This is due to elastic fibers of the skin. When the stress is increased or maintained, the skin becomes viscous, which is again due to the presence of collagen fibers. After this, when the stress is increased or maintained, it causes little further extension of the skin. After this extension, the skin tries to absorb the stress until it is released or to a rupture point. The histochemical nature of the collagen fibers. When the stress is produced by the teeth on the skin, the histochemical changes in the collagen fibers occurs. This is responsible for the varied appearance of the bite marks in different anatomical locations, as well as its effects in the analyzing and describing the bite mark. Distortion. Distortion is again of two types, primary and secondary. Primary distortion is of again two types, dynamic distortion and tissue distortion. This cannot be occurs at the time of bite and cannot be prevented. Secondary distortion. This is of three types, time, posture, and photographic distortion. which can be corrected, and there are steps to correct it. The understanding of bite marks is not complete without knowing about the uniqueness of the human dentition. Studies like McPherson et al., Soganes, and Rosen supports the uniqueness of the human dentition. But the recent studies are based on geometric morphometric analysis, 2D and 3D anatomical landmark techniques, cautions about the uniqueness of the human dentition. So I wish to conclude that bite marks are not an imprint or impression, rather than the reactive response of the injured skin, which invariably shows less recording than the direct recording. Also, Robert Dorian says there are 100 bite marks factors affecting the bite mark dynamics. So before starting the bite mark analysis, you should know about the appearance, anatomical location, distortion based on scholastic nature, non-linearity, anisotropic nature of the skin, posture, and the force of the bite marks. Even the funding also plays an important role for the future research in the field of bite marks. Again, I wish to conclude that bite marks should be used as a collaborative and exculpatory evidence rather than an inculpatory evidence. Thank you. These are my references.